Hello, welcome back to Let's Play a Planescape Torment Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We are in the town or village of Curst. We haven't looked at the map yet. That's the Traitor's Gate Tavern, the dump, the blacksmith, the grain silo, and to Inner Curst, which I guess is where we're ultimately going to be heading.
Attention, Mort. I have a question. What is the rule of three?
Anna, far from grace, and yours truly, bathing in a Cimmerian mud flat.
The Cimmerian.
That conflicts with several previous definitions.
Hey, some people read the dictionary, others write it.
All right, can we go in here? A woman named Lady Roberta is involved in plans to kill her husband, Carl. I think he's one of the burger's assistants. Okay, we talked to her at the end of the last episode. Lady Roberta? His forehead creases in thought. We'll look into this. He looks away. Oh, thanks. Wait, isn't there a reward for this? He smirks. Virtue is its own reward, right? You want more than that? Go talk to somebody in charge. Then I'd like to talk to whoever's in charge. What, the burger? He's in the administration building. Good luck getting to him, though. He don't see anyone these days. His mind's definitely going someplace else. Okay, so this isn't a place we can go. Yeah. How do I get into the tavern? Where's the door? Oh. Alright. These people don't generally talk to us. Yeah, we've seen that last time. What? Can't you see I'm busy? If I wanted to speak with you, I'd have started the conversation myself. These people are jerks. Nabat. Let's talk to Nabat. You see an angel-faced man, his eyes squinting nearly shut, as if unwilling to watch the world's horrors or to let the world see the horrors inside him. And yet his face is creased with smile lines. His voice is friendly and lackadaisical as he greets you. Hi. I had some questions for you. What'd you want to know? What can you tell me about this place? What, the Traitor's Gate Tavern? It's run by a tainted Baris over there and frequented by the folks you see here. Marquez, ex-harmonium. Kitla, ex-employee. Dallin, ex-just about everything. And do I ever have some stories about him that maybe I'll tell you sometime? And Donna Quisho, whose story I don't know yet. Who are you? Me? I'm Nabat. One-time raconteur, now reduced to selling stories in alehouses. I'm retired for now. Maybe I'll give you a story later. Maybe. You want anything else? I'm looking for a deva. His face crinkles in a smile. What makes you think I know anything about that? Seriously. What'd you want to know? Nothing, thanks. Farewell. He doesn't take us seriously.
Done.
I'm not interested in whatever it is you want. Leave me alone. The hotel registry holds many names. A large number of them look like they're in the same hand, like someone was trying to hide the fact that they've been coming here for far too often.
All right. Done.
Well, we'll stick to this floor from now. It's a pretty big place. Dallin.
Hi. Right.
Thank you. You see a tall man with shoulder-length black hair and piercing blue eyes. Wherever he looks, he seems to Wherever he looks seemed to smolder under his gaze. Standing next to him is a quiet young woman who smiles vaguely at all he says. He turns those bright blue eyes at you and smiles largely. He offers his hand. I'm Dallin. Pleased to meet you. I have several ways to say goodbye to him. I had a few questions. What would you need to know? I heard there's a Deva in this town. He laughs and shakes his head. You have another question? Yes. What do you know about this Deva? He laughs loudly. All things have their price, and I'm not ready to put a price on that information yet. Maybe later. What have I threatened him? Tell me about your friend there, then. He smirks. She's a friend. That's all you need to know. She dimples slightly at his side and blushes. Tell me about yourself, then. I'm a bard, historian, actor, and all-around entertainer. Fastest fingers in the Outlands. His smile breaks out again, infectious. At least, that's why I tell everyone. Well, thanks. Farewell.
Done.
Get out of my kitchen. Are we in people's way again? Cheese and a steak knife, okay. The cook's face begins to grow red with anger. What? Did you not hear me? Out! Out of my kitchen!
Done.
Go out this way then. Alright, everyone.
Done.
Let's see. Make sure we talk to everyone who's has a name other than Cursed Citizen.
All right.
Oh, there's Kitla, one of the ones he mentioned. You see a tall, striking woman. She stands staring at the walls of the tavern without seeing them, her hands slowly curling into fists and unclenching. When she sees you, her eyes dart across your clothing and gear and then back to your eyes. A sardonic smile crosses her face, and she looks away again. Greetings. She looks back at you and scowls. You always make a habit of talking to strangers? If I need to ask them questions, then yes. What a fascinating life you must lead to do such things. Sadly for you, I'm busy. I'd appreciate being left alone. I just had a few questions. What part of I'm busy did you not understand? Leave me alone. Thank you. She turns her attention back into herself, losing herself in thought. She begins chewing on her lower lip, and beads of blood sprout from it. Farewell, then. Some issues there. Donna Kishol. You see a red-haired woman, short and plump. Her face is lined with cares, worries, and hatreds that seem to have festered for far too long. She sneers at your approach and turns her head away so that you cannot see her eyes. She acts as though you can't see her if she can't see you. To her, you do not even exist. Farewell, then. Whoa, whoa. Talk to another random cursed citizen. This person turns, eyes narrowed and sneering as you interrupt them. Taking in your appearance at a glance, their expression softens into mere tight-lipped frown. They give you a grudgingly respectful nod and turn away again. Okay, let's talk to this checkup person. So let me look at these people. As Mark has. Tainted bars, okay. You see a drunken guard. He's dressed in the armor of Curst's finest, but it looks like all he's interested in protecting is his bub. He looks you over without much interest, his eyes dead. Who are you? Check up loot. One of Curst's elite. He belches. What are you doing here? He points and tainted Boris, watching him. They say he's got a tunnel here, and I want to see him use it to see if it's true. Waiting? Watching? Go away now. I got watching to do. Oh, well then. Speaking of the man himself, we can look at this stuff here. A frosty mint candy. We can't look at it. So we just take it. Oh, let's talk to him first. You see a haggard, grim man. His coarse face is lined and weathered, and his eyes are red-rimmed. He straightens as he sees you. Welcome to the Traitor's Gate. I'm Tainted Barris, the innkeep. What kind of a name is that? He glares at you. Barris is my given name, Burke. I got the Tainted later because of some former friend spreading baseless chant. He looks very angry. What the hell do you want, anyway? You an adventurer or something? What are you selling here? Listen, damn. I hate to make a request of a stranger, but I think I can help you if you can help me. He continues in a rush. My daughter got kidnapped. She's going to be sold. I'm going to lose this place if I don't have her to help me, and I have information that could be very valuable to you. You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours, see? What do you need?
Updated my journal.
Go over there and talk to Marquez. He's the ex-Harmonium fellow. He knows about these slavers, and he holds the first part of a key that'll put you on the path of seeing a Deva. And you know I need to see a Deva. There are 5 parts to the key, but it ain't a physical key. When you've got the parts together, you come tell me, and it unlocks knowledge in my mind. That's a special, isn't it? Till then, though, it stays secret. You gotta satisfy the key holders. Let me think about it. I had some more questions. What do you want to know? What's with the town being so abandoned?
Updated my journal.
Heh. Troubles aplenty, as always. First, they keep digging holes in the ground to make the prison bigger, and they discover this Deva wrapped up in a big obsidian bubble, chained to the floor. They take his sword and use its power to keep the criminals in their cages. They're busy debating what to do about the Celestial, tearing their hair out trying to figure out how they can make a profit off its discovery and cross their friends. And then the plague hits. Plague?
Updated my journal.
That's right. Something that lays folks low. Makes people all ornery and bad-tempered, and too weak to do anything about it. The guards have closed off portions of the town, and they're all tight-wound. They'll take you into jail on the slightest pretext these days. I don't know how you got into town, but you ain't getting out unless you find a portal. Okay. What can you tell me about this place? What this place is a hotbed of rumors and innuendo. No one trusts no one. You don't do favors for something without someone without making sure they're in your debt. Everyone hates everyone else, and everyone's looking for a hole to get on everyone. Someone like you, you're a ripe target of opportunity for people because you don't know the politics. And I guarantee you'll be sucked in. Throat's a little dry here. What do you know about the Deva? He smiles craftily. You're looking for him, ain't you? I can tell that he's hidden far beneath the prison. I can tell you how to get there, too, apart from being arrested or trying to bribe your way in, which wouldn't work anyway. What do I have to do for this? Yeah, that thing. Oh, rent? Rooms. He doesn't have the better charms. You know what, though? Never mind. See if I have anything else here. Using that now. So we can't sell the bone dagger. Oh, I can, okay. So this, he's trying to hide the anxious look in his eyes as he asks his question. Have you found anything out about my daughter? I'm very worried about her. Please tell Marquez if you hear anything. Rusty mint candy invokes friends. This small round bit of hard candy makes the devourer's breath so winter cool and frosty minty fresh that their charisma is increased considerably for a period of time. It's pretty neat. Sip. Alright, let's talk to Marquez. Oh wait, there was a question mark here, wasn't it? This long wooden bar has been polished to a deep mahogany shine. And these people are just the cursed citizens. That's the con. Someone over there we can talk to, I think. Or did we already do that? You see a burly blonde man wearing the armor of a harmonium officer. His face is rosy with drink, and behind his smile, his eyes are filled with bitterness. He launches into speech without preamble. Here's the deal. Slavers have kidnapped Barsa's daughter. It's your job to help get her back. I'll tell you where to find them. You go kill them and report back to me, and I'll help you to find the Deva you're looking for. I'll even teach you weapons. Agreed? I have a few questions about something else. A few questions? There are only two possible answers. Are you for slavery or against it? Excuse me. I'm against it. Then you'll help, right? Yes or no? I'll help. Last I heard, the slavers were to the east and inner cursed. They've got the nod from the city guard. Find them, make sure Barsa's daughter is all right, and kill them. When you're done, come back here, and I'll tell you the first part of the key you need to find a Deva. All right. Answer some questions about this for me.
Updated my journal.
What? Who are you? I'm Marquez, formerly a Measure 3 of the Harmonium. Formerly, I said, because I quit not so long ago. Why? I found out that the Harmonium, a group I'd believed in from the start, was buying people, kidnapping them, taking them against their will, and ruining their lives. I was sucking the life out of people for daring to be different, and I couldn't take it anymore. The slavers you'll be fighting are old comrades of mine. He spits on the floor. Burks. Liars. You can't trust anyone anymore. What are you doing here? Drinking. What does it look like? I'm waiting for someone to come along and right the wrongs I've made. You seem like a good fellow for the job. What wrongs? Same thing, okay. What's your stake in this slavery thing anyway? It all leads back to this, okay. Where are those slavers again? Yeah. And what can you tell me about the key? 5-part key, verbal. Held in our heads. He smiles toothily at you. You won't get it out of me by torture, and I suspect you won't find the others easy either. We've locked away a secret, and you'll need all 5 parts to find out what it is. Thanks. Farewell. Alright.
Alright.
Alright. Okay, I guess that's it. Oh, wait, we got an upstairs we can go to.
Endure.
I think, therefore, I am.
Enduring, grow strong.
I think.
Yes.
All right. All right. Done.
It's all this crap. Are you ready yet? Someone says. Barog? You hide back there? You see a mousy man with darting, frightened eyes. Please don't hurt me, he stage whispers. They'll kill me if they find me. Who will kill you? The guards. They're after me. I think I offended someone with a question, or said something to the wrong person. I was just offering an opinion, but it seems like you have to speak in a certain way here. It's all corrupt. Who are you, anyway? I'm Barog Quickshoes, traveler and problem solver. I guess you could call me a thief, but I prefer to call myself an engineer. Traps and puzzles and so forth. I only use my skills for good ends. I hate to harm anyone. I guess that they use engines for different purposes here. He shudders. What are you doing here? I came to Curse because I'd heard there was a Deva trapped here, and since I have some Archon friends back in Mount Celestia, I thought I could be of assistance. This town, though, this place is a cesspool, and I can't trust anyone. How can people live like this? I need to get out of here. Tell me of Mount Celestia. His eyes go dreamy. All things have their place there, and all things are beautiful. Hosts of winged Archons wheel in the skies, and exquisite patterns that could break your heart. The fruit grows larger, the game bigger, and all homes are open. Yet we strive to better ourselves constantly, testing our virtue and moving ourselves ever closer to goodness. I should get home as soon as I can. Who's trying to kill you? Where are you from? Okay, then go. He looks at you with disbelief in his eyes. Thank you. You'll not see me again. He scampers away. Farewell. Oh, you needed my permission, huh? You're not scampering away. You're still sitting there.
Done. All right.
Oh, come on. Please, everyone out. We'll just have Nameless One look around.
Done.
Works better that way. There's nothing there. Oh, somebody's standing there. Hello. What the? I know I locked that door behind me. Get out, will you? Almost. Someone behind the screen?
All right.
Yeah. This tawdry, scantily clad woman smiles coyly, shrugging off one of her brassiere straps as you approach her. 20 coins, Cutter, and I'm yours. Actually, I had some questions. She sighs and tugs her brassiere back up. No, sorry, not going to happen. Tell me what's going on with the guard outside, at least. Oh, him? She looks over to the burly guardsman in the doorway, his back to the room as he peers down the hall. My friends and I just slip him some jink to watch out for us, is all. Why? He making you nervous? Don't worry. He won't watch. Come here. She opens her arms to you. Eh? With the others here? Why not? She smiles wickedly, playing with her hair. If it looks like enough fun, mayhap they'll join in. She winks and motions you towards her. Sure. Why not? Here's the coin. You finish your sordid little thing. Fling, actually. Dress yourself and gather your belongings. You don't tire easily, do you? Well, come and see me again. Soon, if you like. Farewell. Maybe I will. Farewell. Anna pissed. The burly cursed guardsman looks you up and down. It's not me you want to be talking to, Cutter. It's them. He motions to a number of attractive, if somewhat tawdry-looking women in the room behind him. And be kind when you do, Cutter. Don't play rough with the ladies. Actually, it is you I wanted to talk to. He shakes his head. Through the narrow slit in his helm, you can see his eyes roll. He doesn't speak another word to you. What about this one? Does she have something else to say? No.
Done. All right. Locked. All right.
I'll have Anna try to open that in a bit. Mayhap it's my own blasted fault if I forgot to lock the door, but I'd rather you weren't in my room just now. Out, please. They motion towards the door. Same. Ungrateful tramp, he says. A worthless sod. Are they having a great time with each other?
Done.
And unfortunately, I can't get past them to look at what's there. Okay. Alright, Anna, do your stuff.
Might as well.
Mm-hmm.
Got it. Why not? Might as well.
Okay, fight time. I like this theme, it's awesome. Oh, he hits hard. Make sure the hammer is not something special, though.
All right. All right.
Nothing, huh? That's what we did, just to fight this guy? Just look, see if I can look back here. Yeah, there's nothing. All right.
Done.
That's pretty random. Those people are still insulting each other over there.
I'm gone.
He's gone.
Done.
I have it under good authority that he's gone. Alright, so that was the Traitor's Gate Tavern. Thanks for watching. See you next time when we explore more of Curst and see if we can, we're not going to enter Curst yet. We might make it to there next episode. I'm going to track down those slavers and find the Deva. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.